like the movie Fiddler-on-Glove. Did you ever see Fiddler-on-Glove? Or the movie or the play? It was a human story of a Jewish family having to become refugees because of the persecution by the government. The family was forced to split up, but the father kept on exhorting to live the life that was handed down through tradition. "Why do we have to do this, Pop?" they said. The children asked. "Because it was tradition." He kept exhorting his children to keep handing down the tradition of the past that kept the families together. I was the youngest in my family, and I got my hand-me-downs from my brother. I've got his shoes, his sweaters, and his shirts. Sometimes I objected, was handed down to me, but at other times I was happy to wear my brother's shirts and shoes, and sometimes his shoes. But there were other things that my father and my mother handed down to me. The love for the Blessed Sacrament, love for my Mass, and especially love for Mary. "Why do we have to go to church to do Mary's Novena?" "Because of tradition," they would educate me and tell me. Today, all three readings speak of tradition. One underlying word in all three readings is the place of sin in all of the readings. As Isaiah experienced the holiness of God, he realized how much of a sinner he really was. Paul realized his own personal sins, and he refers to how he was persecuting the church at his time, a sinful act. And Peter looked at Jesus and says, "Depart from me, because I am a sinful man." How has our world handed down the tradition of the reality of sin? Most of them say it's a mistake. When we were bad on purpose, that's a definition of sin, or refused to love, another definition of sin. Only when Isaiah acknowledged his own sinfulness were his lips touched by a seraphim. The word seraphim means touched with fire, or cleansed and forgiven. Once Paul acknowledged his own sinfulness, he said, "But for the grace of God, I am what I am." Only after Peter prayed and said, "Forgive me, Lord, for I am a sinner," did Jesus say, "Don't be afraid, I've called you to be fishers of men." In these traditions, and we have our own traditions in your home, have you handed down a tradition that is a sense of sin in your home? Or we just make mistakes now, or bad judgment? Or have you handed down a tradition of sin? Have you handed down the tradition that to live the Ten Commandments is your answer to Jesus? Yes, you're called to feed the flock that you have. Once you handed down the tradition of sin and the tradition of the Ten Commandments. That tradition really is summarized in a simple prayer. "Lord, help me to love you with my whole heart and to love others as you love them." Imagine if every family were handed down the tradition of loving God and our neighbor for God's sake and doing it God's way. Love that's handed on would continue to be handed on. In the past few days, everyone was preparing for the northern eastern snowstorm. The grocery stores were overflowing with customers. People were getting their generators in place. Everyone was bracing for the expected storm. And we were watching the weather forecast in advance. But God is different. He doesn't give us a warning in advance of His grace and of His love and our call to follow Him. God sent a seraphim who unexpectedly touched the lips of Isaiah to become full of God's grace and bring God's blessing to the people. Jesus appeared unexpectedly without a TV announcement to Saul and invited him to become Paul and become the apostle of the Gentiles. A And Jesus asked Peter to cast his net on the other side, and Peter unexpectedly brought in a catch of fish whose net could not hold. But there was one thing in common. All of God's appearances occurred in the ordinary circumstances of each of their lives. There was nothing extraordinary in the circumstances of their lives. So it is in the ordinary circumstances of our life and mine that come with his grace and awareness and our awareness of our neighbor's needs and our call to grow in faith and announce it to others as God comes unexpectedly without a weather report. None of these people, Isaiah, Paul, or Peter, were prepared for their calling. No one had handed down the tradition so that God loved them before they were born, and so our vocation is to return that love of honesty, down, handing down our faith, hope, and love that was handed down to us. There is a phrase in Latin that says, "Nemo dat quod non habet." No one can give what one does not have. But on the other hand, we can hand down the tradition God has given to us, the tradition of Lent, where for 40 days we are called to hand down to others our prayer life, our fasting, and our generosity. Gifts of our time, talent, and treasure. I hear so many people make out their will so they can hand down all of their money and possessions to the children and grandchildren. But all of us still have time to hand down a lasting tradition of your love for God and to love your neighbor as yourself. Why? Because it is a tradition.